Hello viewers, welcome to Akshita's Creation. This is Sindhu. Biryani is something that we all enjoy. Today we are going to do a very nice and easy gobi biryani, that is a cauliflower biryani. It is a very simple and quick recipe. We are going to use very simple ingredients which we use it in our day-to-day cooking. So it will be very easy for us to make this biryani. It will taste very delicious. We are going to prepare this biryani in pressure cooker. It will be very easy to make. So everyone do try it in your home. So let's get started and check out the recipe. In order to make cauliflower biryani, I have taken one medium sized cauliflower and I have cut it into big pieces and washed it with warm water. Now I am going to season the cauliflower with simple masalas. I am going to add 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, 3 tablespoons of fresh curd, 1/2 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste, 1 little salt. We have to mix it well and toss it all together so that the masalas will get mixed into the cauliflower. The reason why I have seasoned the cauliflower is to give the vegetable a nice flavor. Make sure the masalas is coated to the cauliflower nicely. Rest the cauliflower for about 15 minutes. I am going to make the cauliflower biryani in a pressure cooker. So place a pressure cooker over a stove and preheat it. Once the pressure cooker gets heated, now I am adding 3 spoons of refined oil. Initially I am adding 3 spoons of refined oil. You can add extra oil so that it will taste very good. Add 2 bay leaves, 1 star anise, few cinnamon and few cloves. Allow it to get roasted. Now I am going to add 2 medium sized onions thickly sliced and allow it to become golden brown. The onions should change to nice golden brown color. Now I am going to put 1 green chilli lightly slit. Now mix it well. Now I am going to add 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste and saute it well. I have taken 10 meal maker and soaked it in water for about 10 minutes and then squeeze it out the extra water, and we have to cut the meal makers into small pieces. Now we are going to add this into the cooker. Mix it well. Now I am going to add 1 handful of mint leaves. It will give a very nice flavor for our biryani, so we are adding the mint leaves. Now let us add 2 medium sized tomatoes, cut it into small pieces, saute it well. The tomatoes become little mushy. Now let's add the seasoned cauliflower. You can see it is coated beautifully. Now let us add 1 tablespoon of chili powder and 1 tablespoon of garam masala to it. And I am adding 2 tumblers of water since I have taken 1 tumbler of rice. So for 1 tumbler of rice I am adding 2 tumblers of water. I have taken only normal rice. Now let's add salt to taste. I have washed and soaked 1 cup of normal rice for about 1 hour. At this stage, we can add the washed and soaked rice into the cooker. Instead of the normal rice, you can use basmati rice too. But I have taken normal rice. After adding the rice, let's add few mint leaves to it. it will give very nice flavor. And I'm going to add 1/2 spoon of lemon juice to it. Now close and pressure cook on high flame for about 3 whistles. Now I'm placing a pan on the stove and adding 3 tablespoons of ghee to it. Now let's add 1 cup of cashews into it. This is about 10 cashews. I have cut it into pieces. Roast it to golden brown color. Now take the roasted cashews and keep it aside. I have taken 2 slices of bread and I have cut it into small pieces. Now I am going to roast the bread in the same ghee. While taking out the bread, we have to squeeze it out the extra ghee. Now take out the roasted bread slices and keep it aside in a plate. Now let us open the cooker. The cauliflower biryani is done and it looks absolutely delicious. Now let's add 1 spoon of ghee over it. It gives very good flavor. It is cooked perfectly. Now let us add the bread pieces. It will give very good taste. Now let's add the cashews, roasted cashews. The roasted cashews and roasted bread will give extra taste to our biryani, so that we are adding this. The roasted bread and roasted cashews are totally optional. If you need, you can add it. But it will give a very good taste. See, our cauliflower biryani is ready. It is cooked perfectly. You can serve it hot with a nice onion raita by the side. This is a very nice and easy recipe that you can try at your home. It is a very quick recipe. Next time when you buy a cauliflower, or if you have cauliflower at your home, do try it at your home and enjoy this delicious recipe along with the raita, and post your comments without fail. Do subscribe our channel for more interesting recipes. Thanks for watching and keep supporting us.